So one of the things you may already know how to do is to create a PDF from anything you're viewing by simply going to File, then Print, and then choosing from this PDF menu here, and you can choose to save as PDF or open in preview as a PDF. But there's some other items that appear here. Some of these I've added in previous tutorials. Some of these are here by default, like Add to iBooks. There's one that's been around for a long time that you may have noticed called Save to Web Receipts. This is supposed to be a special function that when you see a receipt pop up, say you purchase something online, you get to that final page after the sale is done and it's a receipt and you want to save that receipt, you can simply choose this one. And not only does it save it as a PDF, but it will save it in a special web receipts folder. Where is this web receipts folder? Well, it will appear in your documents folder. And you can see there it actually just popped into place. It's because I didn't have it previously on this user account. It creates it in your user documents folder, creates this web receipts folder, and in it there's the PDF with the web page. This is kind of handy, but what would be even better is if you can create more than just web receipts. You can create your own folders. It turns out you can do this very easily. So let's go back up here. I'm going to do Command Up to go back to the documents folder. I'm going to create a new folder, Command Shift N to create a new folder, and I'm going to create just a folder called Interesting Articles. And now I'd love to have that as an option where I can save as a PDF anything to interesting articles without having to go save as PDF and then find this interesting articles folder. So one place you can do that is I can create a new Finder window here, and I'm going to choose Go, and I'm going to hold the Option key down to select Library. If you don't see Library there, you need to hold down the Option key. Otherwise, it may not appear. And in here, you'll actually see a folder called PDF Services. And I'm going to go in there, and there's an actual automator workflow I created before that's in there. You may find that it's blank. Matter of fact, you may find that it doesn't exist, in which case it's okay to create PDF services in your library folder. Note, you have to use Go with the Option key and then choose Library, or you'll end up in your system library folder, which is okay, but it's probably not what you want. You want it to be in your user library folder. So what do you do here? Well, I'm going to drag and drop this interesting articles folder here, but I'm going to hold down the command and the option key, and this will create an alias, and you can see the curved arrow there. I don't want to move interesting articles there. I want to create an alias to it. So the interesting articles folder remains in my documents folder, and an alias to it is in PDF services. Now I'm going to go back here into Safari, and I'm going to go Print, and I'm going to look under PDF, and sure enough there is interesting articles. And when I use that and I go back to the Finder and I look at my interesting articles folder, there it is. Another cool thing you can do is you can change the name of this alias. Aliases can have their own names. They don't have to have the same names as the original thing. So I can do Save As Interesting Articles or Save To Interesting Articles. So you can see that's the name of the alias, but the folder remains the same. So now when I go to Print and I look here, I can see it says Save To Interesting Articles. Now notice this Edit menu here at the bottom. I can actually go into that and I get this little thing here, and it shows me Save To Interesting Articles. It recognizes that alias there. It also recognizes the script I've got there. I can add more with plus, and I can choose another folder. So for instance, let's go to my documents folder and let's select the projects folder that's in there. I'll hit open, and you can see it adds projects. And I can also click and edit the name, so I can say Save To Projects, and now I get Save To Projects there as well. And you think, well, that's another way to do it and I don't have to create the alias. It actually creates the alias for you. Here I am looking in the PDF Services folder, and notice it created the alias for me. So there's two ways to do exactly the same thing. You may want to do this Edit menu just to make it a little cleaner, a little easier to do, a few less steps. Now note, you could also, instead of adding aliases to folders, you can add aliases to applications here as well. I can do that by dragging an alias to an application in here, or I can use that same menu here, Edit Menu, and add an application there. So I'm going to drag a alias, I'm going to hold Command and Option to do it, drag an alias to Adobe Acrobat. Now when I go to Print and I choose PDF, you can see that Acrobat Pro appears as an option there. When I select it, it will create the PDF and will open it up in Acrobat Pro. Of course, it has to be an application that handles PDFs. You can't just select any application. So keep that in mind. But it is handy. You can add all different applications you use that handle PDFs in there. You can add folders in there. And you can really customize it as you want. Notice that if I go back to Edit Menu, I see Acrobat Pro appears there as one of the things that I can add. So I can add applications. I can add folders, or aliases to folders really is what I want. And I can add scripts, which is a whole other subject. We'll be right back.